welcome to another edition of Feel This Pain. I'm Ken McKim, and tonight we're going to be talking a little bit about something known as Sjögren's disease. Now, if you were to do a cursory Google search on Sjögren's, you might come away thinking, it's no big deal, it's just dry mouth and dry eyes, right? It's much more than that. Sjögren's is an autoimmune disease that causes your lymphocytes to attack your exocrine glands, which are responsible for producing moisture in the eyes, mouth, and other tissues. It is much more than just a syndrome that makes your mouth dry and your eyes gritty. Now, many patients experience dry eyes and dry mouth, but also fatigue and joint pain because of the inflammation that Sjögren's can cause. And, you know, a dry mouth is not a benign thing to have. Think about it, without saliva, you don't digest food as well because saliva is the first step in the digestion process. Also, without saliva production, your teeth are almost guaranteed to decay and you are much more prone to oral infections. So what is Sjögren's? There are basically two kinds of Sjögren's: primary, where it occurs on its own, and secondary, where it appears with another autoimmune condition like rheumatoid arthritis or lupus. Sjögren's can affect the nervous system, resulting in peripheral neuropathy, which is damage to the nerves in the arms and legs, which causes pain, numbness, and weakness, or cranial neuropathy, which is the same thing in your face with a loss of taste and smell on top of it. It can also affect the kidneys with glomerular nephritis, which is inflammation of the kidney's filter, resulting in edema, blood in the urine, and reduction in the amount of urine produced. Sounds fun, right? No. Sjögren's can also affect the lungs, inflaming the air sacs, causing them to thicken and scar, which can make breathing very difficult. So are there treatments? Well, of course there are. It's an incurable condition, but you can treat the symptoms. Now, as far as medications that increase production of saliva, there are a couple you may have heard of. One's called Salagen and the other is Avoxic. You should be able to get those from your doctor without too much trouble. If you develop the arthritic systems that can sometimes accompany Sjögren's, you might want to talk to your doctor about what are known as non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications, or NSAIDs. Some people have good results with that, but again, you want to talk to your doctor. If over-the-counter eye drops aren't effective for the dry eye, you might need prescription eye drops. There's even a surgical option where they seal off your tear ducts so you retain more moisture in your eyes. It's called a punctal occlusion. But again, it's surgery, albeit minor surgery, so you'll want to think about it before you commit to that kind of an option. Above all, if you meet someone who has Sjögren's, I would encourage you to treat them with all the respect and compassion they deserve, because this is not a cakewalk. This is a very serious condition, which often occurs alongside other serious autoimmune conditions. So give them a break. They deserve it, and you'll be a better person for doing so, right? And that's all the time we have this week. Thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions, please feel free to send them to me, ken@don'tpunishpain.com. You can also follow me over on Twitter, @don'tpunishpain. We're out of time, but I will see you again. And until next time, I'm Ken McKim. You take care.